share my icons with you guys. Somebody had asked for advice on getting icons and setting up their prayer corner, and so I figured I'd show you guys mine. And so this is my Bible, my prayer book. It does have a little makeshift bookmark in there. These are our wedding candles. We just haven't gotten candlesticks for them yet. This is my prayer candle that I like to light when I say my prayers. And then this is my baptismal candle. And this is my husband's chrismation candle. These are our palm leaves from the most recent Palm Sunday. This is the first icon that I purchased. I saw it at my church bookstore and I gasped. I love this icon so much. It just really spoke to me. Talks about a lot. And so this was my first icon, mostly because it spoke to me and I wasn't even catechumen yet. I was an inquirer who just going to the church kind of regularly, and so I didn't really know much of anything about Orthodoxy. When I purchased this icon, I just knew I had to have it. And these are the rest of my icons. I do have one of Saint Valentine down there. But here's our Jesus icon. Focus, there we go. The Theotokos. And then there's my husband's patron saint, Philip the Apostle, and then my patron saint, Eve. And so, after I bought this icon and I started learning more about Orthodoxy, I bought the Jesus icon and then the Theotokos icon. And then in my catechism, as I was preparing to join the church, I got the Saint Eve icon. I also got the Saint Valentine icon because I was considering Saint Valentine as my patron saint, but ultimately chose Eve. And then my husband discovered Orthodoxy because of me, so he didn't have his own icons. He received the St. Philip icon at his chrismation. And then I have a couple of icons over here. After I was brought into the church, I got the resurrection icon because I love it. And then we just received this icon for our wedding. So that one we got recently because we got married. So yeah, I definitely want to add to my icon corner. I love these candles so far. I do like my baptismal candle every so often. I also want incense when this candle runs out, so I can light some incense. And we do. I like to switch out the palm leaves every year. I'm sure we will add more icons as we go, but that was just a quick little icon corner share. So we like to hang out here, and there's no chair or anything. There's a crinkly cat ball under it from my cat. I'll sometimes stand here and say my prayers, or I'll sit on the couch nearby and look at the icon corner and say my prayers. There's not really any rules for how you have to have your icon corner set up. It's more what speaks to you. And this is what works for us. And I hope this helps you. If you are looking for inspiration for your own icon corner, I am actually looking to get an icon of a guardian angel, but I'm just kind of waiting for one to jump out at me, similar to how this icon just spoke to me that one day at church. So I definitely have a few more icons I want to get. So the guardian angel icon, I think I want the crucifixion icon, and the ascension icon to just round out my complement, the resurrection icon I have. And then I guess we'll see what my husband wants to acquire as time goes on. So your icon corner can definitely change. The wedding candles, we might not keep on the icon corner. We might move them to a bookshelf somewhere, but we'll see. So I hope you enjoyed this, and